Hey there, this is Ken Furukawa from kenfurukawa.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a YouTube end card with Canva. This Canva tutorial is a follow-up to my previous video, How to Create a YouTube Thumbnail with Canva, and I've included a link to that video down in the description below. Now, if you don't have a Canva account, I included a link as well, and you can click on that to sign up for your free account. There is no obligation to upgrade to a paid account, okay? You can stay on the free account for as long as you like. Now, obviously, there are perks to being a paid member, and I'm going to show you that, okay? But other than that, I mean, you really can create these end cards using the free account. Now, if you don't know what an end card is, let me show you what one looks like. This is one that I created, okay? You can see here that this shows up about 20 seconds prior to the end of the video. Now, it can be 20 seconds max in length, or it can be shorter than that. It just depends on how you edit your video, okay? Now, YouTube has some generic templates that they provide, okay, to anyone that has a YouTube channel, okay? So you can use those in the beginning, and then when you get comfortable, you can create your own end card. Now, in this case, you can see here, I have a watch next, okay? And this is where I suggest the video that would be probably interesting to the people that are watching this current video. There's also an area for them to subscribe. So if they hover over that, they can subscribe to my channel. And then also right down here, it's kind of hard to see. It says suggested by YouTube. Now this, this video right here is suggested because of YouTube's AI, okay? It's gonna analyze my viewing habits and it's gonna suggest another video from this channel or from my channel for the viewer to watch. Okay, so that's what an end card is. I'm gonna show you how to create one real easy, and then I'm gonna show you how to create your own, okay, from scratch, all right? So first of all you do is you head into the templates library. And once you're in here, you're gonna type into the search term box, YouTube. And you're gonna see YouTube outros. This is the one that you want, okay? They don't have anything that says YouTube end card or end screen. They call it YouTube outro, okay? So you're gonna click on that, and you're gonna see that they've got a ton of templates, okay? And you know, I don't know how long they've had this, okay? But now that I see it, I'm probably gonna create a new one later on and experiment with that. I created my own, but had I known that this was out there, it would be so much easier. So again, you can choose one that's animated if you want. Some of these have a video in the background as well. So you're really, you know, only limited to your imagination, but they provide you with so much design templates and ideas, okay? So let me just show you how easy it is to edit one. So we're gonna choose this one right here, okay? And you're gonna click on use this template. This is a standard one. This one does not have any video in the background, okay? So here, I'm just gonna change the colors, okay? You can customize it to whatever you like. I wanna choose red, okay? And there's a secondary color here which adds this nice little kind of fade here, okay? And then you can change the color of this arrow here. You can change the text, the size, the color, everything, okay? The type of font if you want. I'm gonna change the color over here. This is super easy to do, okay? We'll choose blue. Okay, and let's say you like that, it looks nice, and you want to go with that. Then you're going to click on publish, and you're going to download. And you can save it as a PNG, but you can't save it with a PNG background, with a transparent background, I should say. That's only reserved for people who have a paying account, okay? But typically what I like to do is save it as a JPEG. If there is no need for any transparency, I save it as a JPEG. And I increase the quality to 100%, okay? And we're gonna download this to our computer, and then let's check it out, okay? So here is the new end card, okay? It looks nice, and this is what you would drop into your video with about 20 seconds or less left in your video, and this is where you'd be able to add in your subscribe button or suggested video or whatever it is that you want. Now, let's say that you want to create your own, okay? How are you gonna do that, right? Well, one of the best ways to do it is to mimic your favorite YouTuber, okay? So if you're watching a video and you notice that the YouTuber has a nice end card, then you can go ahead and copy that. So here's an example, okay? This is Justin Brown, okay? He has a channel called Primal Video, Really awesome content. I suggest you follow him if you're not already. And one way that you can do this, this is how I got started before I knew Canva had their own templates, was I would just take a screenshot of this. So let's go ahead, take a screenshot of this end card here. Okay, we're gonna follow as close as possible to the size of this video. Okay, and then let's take a look. So this is what it looks like. What we're gonna do is we're gonna create our own, okay? I'll show you how to do that. So let's go all the way up to the top. It says create a blank outro. So now we're gonna have a blank canvas, okay? And then we're gonna create it from here, and it's super easy. So we're gonna go into uploads, and we're going to upload that screenshot that we just took. Okay, and there it is. So we're gonna upload it, and we're gonna drop it onto our canvas. Okay, and now we're gonna stretch this all the way out till it fits perfectly. That's nice right there, okay? Now, you're probably wondering, okay, so how are we gonna do this? Okay, first of all, what we're gonna do is we're going to select it, and we're going to change the transparency. We're going to lower it down to about, let's say, 50%, okay, so we can see it. And then we're going to overlay the shapes over them, okay? So this area is going to be transparent, okay? Now one way you can get around the transparency not having that available to you because you're on the free account is to do this in PowerPoint, okay? So you can do the exact same thing in PowerPoint, save your template as a PNG with a transparent background, and you will have the exact same the same type of template, okay? I'm gonna show it how you do it in Canva. So first of all, you lower the transparency, then we're gonna head over to Elements, and we're going to recreate these boxes right here, okay? So we're gonna choose the box, and we're gonna try and line it up as best we can to the shape of that box, okay? To the same size, okay? So let's go ahead, that looks about good, okay? And then we're just gonna make a copy of this, okay? And then we're gonna paste it. And we're gonna drop it right over the other one, okay? Now, for my end card, okay? I made mine gray as well, okay? But you can make it any color you want. So let's say we make this black, okay? So let's color that black. Let's color this black. Okay. Now that looks good. Now we need to create a circle for the subscribe button. Okay, so this thing right here. Okay. So let's go ahead, choose the circle shape, and then we're going to align this, and we're going to shrink it down to about the same size as our sample here. Okay. Now that looks good. We're going to color that black, okay? So all this does is it serves as a placeholder so that when you do add in the videos that you want to, you can just drop them onto these areas right here, and it'll look nice, okay? So now we need to do this part right here, this blue part, okay? This angle right here. So we're just gonna take the square, okay? We're gonna extend it out, and then what we're gonna do is, you see down here, there's a little handle here, and you can rotate this, okay? So we're gonna just slide this over, and we're gonna see if we can, it's pretty close, if we can copy his angle. And this looks good right here, okay? And we're gonna change that to, let's change it to another color. How about we change it to, let's change it to red, okay? All right, so now that we've got that set, what we can do is we can get rid of this original photo here. So let's delete that. And then now you're wondering, where are the two black rectangles, right? So what we need to do is we need to send this all the way to the back, okay? So you're gonna select it, and you're gonna go to position and send to back, okay? And there you have it, right here, okay? So when you're ready and you're satisfied with it, you're gonna click on publish, and you're gonna download. Now, again, I have the transparent background feature because I'm a pro member, okay? As a free member, you won't have that, okay? I'm just going to show you what you can do in the pro version first, okay? So you just would save it, and we're going to take a look at that. Let's open it up. There you go. This is the template, okay? And you can tell right here it's a little bit grayed out. This is because this part is transparent, so that when we load it, you're going to see that it looks just like this, okay? And this is where you're going to drop your video, okay? So this area right here, this is where your video is going to be. Now, again, if you do not have the pro account, you will not be able to save it as a PNG transparent background, okay? So you can either do this in PowerPoint, or you can go ahead and choose, you can choose a different one altogether. So let's go ahead, one that doesn't have a one that doesn't have a transparent background or a need for one, okay? So any of these right here, any of these, like this one doesn't have a need to have the video playing, right? Because all you're gonna do is you're gonna just drop your subscribe button and another video right here, okay? So you would choose something like this to edit, okay? And, you know, again, if you want to add your photo, you can change the background and maybe add a picture of yourself in the background, change this text, maybe make it a little bit smaller, but you know, you'd keep this the same. You would leave this exactly the same, and you would download this and use it as your end card. So very, very simple. I mean, you can tell how powerful Canva is, with so much features, so much templates that you can utilize. But there you go. That's how you create a YouTube end card with Canva. Now, if you have any questions, please drop them in the comment section below. If you found this video to be helpful, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. And if you're looking to take your newfound YouTube skills to the next level and drive free organic traffic to your affiliate marketing offer, then click on the link below to follow a proven step-by-step blueprint called the Simple Traffic Blueprint and start your online business today. This is Ken Furukawa from kkfurukawa.com. And I'll see you in my next video. Cheers.